The time has come. Execute Order 66.
Anybody ever notice when you're sitting there listening to something and you know it's bullshit? When you absolutely know it's bullshit and you look around and you realize nobody else around you realizes that it's bullshit but you? Case in point. All right, so today at Celebration, Kathleen Kennedy, desperate to keep her job or her golden parachute, announced that they are developing with Charmaine Chinoy a movie set in the Star Wars universe 15 years after the sequel trilogy. Translation, I'm desperate to protect my Star Wars legacy. I don't give a fuck if I destroyed Star Wars. I need this movie. Or something like that. Pretty much that's what this is. And the idea that if we go back and look, Marvel has been capped on budgets and on TV shows. And it's interesting to note that while this crap movie, I can't stop laughing. You know, Disney should just allow her to make it so she can watch it flop harder than Solo. And by the way, this is Charmaine Chinoy, the bullshitter documentarian who almost ruined Ms. Marvel. Okay, this is the person who's never made a feature film in her life that insists she has a movie with Daisy Ridley. Okay, whatever. Anyway, they should just let them make it just so they can watch it flop and then they really have to go away. But we haven't gotten any word from Bob Iger about capping budgets for Star Wars and all the rest of that stuff. It's like it's not there. And Sparrow has said there has been no word about that. Next year we don't have Star Wars Celebration. All right, but here's Kathy strutting around on the days, announcing projects, another movie with James Mangold set in the far back universe. Maybe we'll get Revan, maybe we'll get Darth Bane, but that could be cool. And Dave Filoni basically announcing for sure that they're doing the movie culmination of the Mandoverse. Okay. So that's actually going to be the sequel trilogy right there, not what Kennedy did, and Kennedy knows that. So she's got to throw Charmaine Chinoy out there, who doesn't have any reason to be connected to any of this. She throws her name out there to make herself part of this. And it doesn't make any sense. She even said, we've had movies in development. Well, yeah, even when you haven't announced any movies, you're always looking at different projects, hoping to make something unusual and something that people would like and that would garner the exec's attention so you could get the green light. But that doesn't mean any of them, not even King Dave's movie, will ever see the light of day, okay? Because it looks to me, the desperation celebration. And, you know, have we heard anything about her stunning victories and everything? No, I don't even know if these are being streamed. I suppose I should go look, but I haven't had the time and I just woke up. So we are just watching this. I'm not surprised that she'd throw bullshit out there like Ray coming back. What the fuck? No one wants Ray. Iger knows that. The numbers don't lie. But this is Kennedy trying to save her precious sequel trilogy characters. And it's like, no one wants this. No one, I mean, and there's probably a reason why this one may have not been streamed with the chat, because fans would freak out. And we've got another thing we're talking about. And I think an even bigger thing that they should have kept their mouths shut on, because they're trying to, look, I've got an explanation, but take a time out with Tarkin.
Do it.
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
The fleet has moved out of light speed and we're preparing to...
You have failed me for the last time, Admiral.
Bob Iger isn't a fool. And he's letting Kennedy go nuts at Celebration for a reason. And she's making it harder for her in the long run with her announcing movies, Charmaine Chinoy's Ray, rah, rah, rah film that'll never see the light of day. Maybe Kathy can make a fan film with her. Okay. They can do it as a fan film. They could crowdfund it. Okay. But this guy right here ain't spending a goddamn dime on that. Okay. He's not stupid. Kennedy is flaying her arms around with other things, like a show that's connected to a very big lawsuit with a lot of scandals. And because it's not connected to Disney, and it's not, I think Kennedy is being allowed to hang herself by her own petard. Now, Disney's lawyers have said, don't say a fucking thing. But they didn't. Okay, and this is an interesting thing, but I see it as Kennedy being allowed to hang herself by her own petard. This is watching her walk into a trap. This whole fucking thing. You know, I really don't understand what she thinks she's doing. And she really is that stupid. And I'm amazed her husband would allow her to do this, but he's right with her. He's there. And it's really interesting watching the Kabuki dance that they're putting on for the fans. And I know people that said they saw the footage and blah, blah, blah. So what? You saw part of a sizzle reel. You actually didn't see anything being filmed. This show has not been greenlit, regardless of what Headland said. This is, I want the footage of her saying this when Disney finally puts this to rest and, she, you know, this lawsuit goes in and she gets thrown under the bus by Kennedy, who would do that immediately to save her own ass. Okay, look, I'm going to say this. It is the Acolyte. They did show footage. And apparently Carrie Ann Moss was in it, but where has she been lately? Okay, did she just show up to start filming? Where's the money coming from? See, they announced this. Disney has nothing to do with it. They have not greenlit it. There's that. Look, the only time I would believe an announcement is if it was at D23 and Bob Iger had said, we are announcing a new Star Wars TV show, The Acolyte, blah, blah, blah. He said nothing. Okay, he said absolutely fucking nothing. And if they find out that there isn't a show being, that first of all, the show that they're filming isn't real, that it's a glorified sizzle reel that she's been putting together, and she's been taking money from other things. Kennedy is gone too. All right, this is not something to just go, oh, they're making it. Where's Kennedy? Like I said, Disney never greenlit, but here's the Kabuki dance. There she is, the Kabuki dancer. Up there in front of the stage with a bunch of, you know, sequel trilogy woke bitches up there doing her interpretive fake dance so they actually believe it's happening. You know, she walked into a trap too. She really, really did. This is so stupid, I can't. For them to do this to me, and you know, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe they do have the money. If that's the case, where'd it come from? Because again, there's never been any official statement about it. Bob Iger said he saw a reel of it and said he liked what he saw. But considering in this situation, what's he going to say, dumbasses? Okay. But he did out loud to everybody and God announce a Moana live film. All right. He said that. The only person who can decide if the Acolyte is going to actually be a real thing is Bob Iger. And the only thing he said in polite company was that he saw it, some of it, and he liked what he saw. That doesn't mean a goddamn thing here. Okay. That means nothing. Okay. That is literally the most a dishonest thing he's ever said, okay? And he's in such a shitty place right now. So let's talk about the only real things that I think that they're doing. The only real announcement that I take, not lightly, is Dave Filoni and the movie that's culminating the end of the Mandoverse, which to me looks like it's a Jon Favreau, Dave Filoni, Heir to the Empire end of it, okay? And this will probably actually be very good. We will probably like it. This is the one thing I'm looking forward to, as well as the James Mangold thing. So were they honest about the Charmaine Chinoy thing? No. Were they honest about the Acolyte? That was an interesting interpretive Kabuki dance, but no. Are they being honest about maybe going forward with a Dave Filoni movie? Yes. But that's about it. Take what, believe me or not, but this is going to be an interesting, tough week for a lot of people. And it's going to get very hard for them going forward as we get closer to Indiana Jones 5, because we're going to hear more rumors coming from inside Lucasfilm that aren't necessarily coinciding with what Headland's little Kabuki dance said, okay? So this is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.